has risen to cult-like popularity as an unbelievably versatile productivity tool. But did you know that you can use Notion to publish your own professional-looking website? The pros are that it's very user-friendly, with thousands of pre-built templates from both Notion and its many, many users worldwide. It can be a one-stop shop for all your needs because of all the different options there are to set up these productivity tools and use the Notion template. Notion is also very inexpensive with little to no cost. There are multiple options for free usage, and when you start to need to pay, the options can start at only $4 a month for unlimited storage and unlimited guest-specific login. Although the analytics aren't very in-depth, because there are so many embedding options, you can easily embed to things that give you more in-depth analytics for how people are using your website. Depending on where in your sales funnel you're using your website, you might decide that you want a more upgraded version. After your sales funnel, you might decide that the Notion free templates are exactly what you need. Even in the Notion free version, you can get very creative with the Notion template by uploading your own photos, images, your own color scheme, and borders to make it look just the way that you want. With the options to use Notion as a website builder, there are various use cases, like as a landing page or a blog. But the one that really stands out with Notion is as a course dashboard. There are so many options for how to use Notion. Alex is going to show you how to set up Notion and publish as a website. For those of you looking for a more customized look, he's also going to show you a couple options for how to do that. Over to Alex.
Hello, and welcome to another video on how you can create a great-looking website for your personal project or startup on a budget. Today, we're looking at Notion. Notion is a fast, flexible web-based productivity tool. With Notion, for a personal account, you can sign up for free. Notion is a great tool for things like taking notes, managing your tasks, keeping track of changes in a project, but that's not what we're here to do. We're here to create and manage a website from within our Notion. The basic process for creating a website in Notion is quite simple. First, we want to create a new page. Once we've created a new page, we just fill in some information. So as an example, we've gone ahead and used one of Notion's built-in templates to give us something to work with. And once we have something to work with, we can go ahead and go up here to the share button and then click share to web. All we need to do is copy this and paste it into a browser. And this is what anyone who goes to that web address will see. It's virtually identical to what we were seeing in Notion, just without the menu. But as you can see, once we've shared to web, there are four other things. This one at the bottom, search engine indexing, is only for paid accounts. So we're not going to worry about that right now. Allowed to duplicate as a template is for other Notion users to be able to copy their own Notion account. Allow comments is pretty straightforward. It allows people with Notion accounts to create comments on your page. And finally, allow editing will allow people who have Notion accounts to make edits to your page. And as a reminder, now that we've clicked share to the web on this page is live on the internet. Any changes we make to this website will be reflected on the website immediately. This is a handy tool if you want to do something quickly, work collaboratively across the internet, or just make updates. You don't have to worry about remembering to publish. Any changes are done immediately. Any user on the website will see them instantly. If you want to do edits to your page without users seeing it as you're doing it, what you'll want to do is come here to dots on the page you're working on, duplicate, and make any changes in the duplicate. Then copy any changes you made back over to your main one. The other thing to keep in mind when you're doing this, any subpages you make within this page are also published to the web. This is good if you need to have nested pages, if you want to create subpages for other information, if you want to build this as a multi-page website. All of the stuff you'd be working on will be underneath the one you've shared to the web, with all of your other stuff accessible to you outside of that. Now, if this is all you need, a simple, straightforward website, and you don't care how it looks, we're done. But there are a couple of drawbacks. First of all, we can't give this a custom domain. We're stuck with what Notion has given us, which you can see here on the actual website is based on our username and the thing we named the page, as well as this long string of characters. And whatever we do to this, it's going to look like a Notion website. There's only so much we can do within Notion. Part of the strength of Notion is that it's very modular, very straightforward. Everything always looks good, but we're very limited in what we can do in order to facilitate that. So there are two main ways we can really improve the look of a Notion website. Both of them involve other websites, and that's what we're going to get into now. The first option we're going to discuss is called the Super Builder. As you can see, we go to super.so/builder, and it takes us directly to this page. Super Builder is a drag and drop system for Notion. It's free unless you want a custom domain or to apply a custom. So this is great for getting a quick start, make a great looking website really fast within Notion. The first thing we do is we click duplicate this builder. That takes us into the builder. In order to put this into our Notion workspace, we click duplicate. And it'll ask us which of our workspaces we want to put it into. And this may take a couple of minutes. Once we successfully duplicated the Super Builder template into our Notion, you'll see a new set of pages on the left here that says Super Builder. To create a new page, we'll go down to Builder. And if we expand this, we'll see that there are instructions on how to use it, how to add themes if you want to, although themes are a page feature, frequently asked questions, and the builder itself. First, what we want to do is create a new page. You'll see it creates a page callout block here, and this is what we create the pages of our website out of. And the way this works is we take components out of the component library here on the left. We're going to start with a hero image, a nice big pretty image at the top of the page. We hold down control, as the instructions say, to copy it from one place to another instead of simply moving it and let go. And now let's drop that component into our page. So you can see we have the components in our page. What we need to do is turn these into text so they show up in the page. So once we have all the parts in the page we want, we first want to turn this callout block into a page. And now we can put this page where we want to put it over here so that it becomes its own heading. And you can see when we click on it, that page now exists here. We can turn on sharing as we did before. This is now a live website. Any edits will show up on the internet as it was before. We can change it as we want. I think make this look a little better. Now, if we preview this on the actual website, you can see how beautiful this looks with virtually no effort. If we want to make a multi-page website, we can create new pages. I'm going to create a couple here just to give us an example. Once we've converted all the parts in the about page to text, we want to turn this into a page. You see it collapses down to a page. It becomes a link that we can put somewhere else on the website. We're going to do the same thing with the shop. Now we can just take this and drop it into our website. They've ended up down here at the bottom. Just drag them up to the top. Drop them right here. I'm going to take these. I'm going to stack them sideways like this to create a menu. So now that we have our website looking like we want to, we want to make sure that sharing is turned on and go to the Super Builder website again. And if you haven't already created an account with them, you want to do so now. Once we've logged into Super, we want to create a new site. We want to give it a name, and here we want to put our Notion page URL, which we get from the sharing menu here. Just click copy here and paste it here. What Super has done here is applied a theme to our website, and it additionally has given us this short link domain. We can change that by going over here to domain. We can change it to whatever we want. When we hit save, you can see up at the top, it says Millionaire Supersite. We click on it, and it will take you to the website. If you've already purchased the domain, you would add the custom domain here. Otherwise, you're going to be whatever you are, .super.site. Adding a custom domain is a paid feature of the Super service. As a quick reminder, before we move on to the next section, anything that you do within the page that you have shared will be visible on the web unless you specifically tell it not to. So everything that you put in underneath, all of this stuff will be shared on the website you set. This brings us to our other option, Fruition. As you can see, you go to fruitionsite.com. This is a free open source toolkit for building websites with Notion. It's more complicated than the other one to set up initially, but it is free. First things first, as with all the other methods we're using, you'll need to start with sharing to the web on our website. And once you've shared it, you will also need to have a domain of some kind. Some good places you can get a reasonably priced domain are Google Domains, Namecheap, or GoDaddy.com. And we can move along to the next step, setting up Cloudflare. This step is a little more complicated than the scope of this video really allows. So I'm going to do this quickly on my own. If you feel comfortable doing this on your own, the instructions on the Fruition website will walk you through it. Otherwise, the video link here will walk you through it with step instructions and examples. So once we've set up Cloudflare and gotten to the point where we can edit the script, we come to this point where we need to put in the addresses for the sites that we want to create. But to get the links we need for pretty links, we have to come in here to our website, click the share button, copy the page link back over here, paste it here, and then we can add a pretty link to our subpages. Go to the page, grab the link from there, label this what it'll be called, and repeat as necessary. And now that we've added our top-level domain and our three pretty links for our three pages, copy the code, we go over to the Cloudflare worker that we set up earlier, select it all, and replace it. One thing about the Fruition method, every time you want to change the links on your websites, they have a pretty URL, you have to go back into the page on fruitionsite.com and reset all of these, copy this script back over into the Cloudflare worker that you set up before. That said, once you have this set up, it's good to go forever, and it's completely free. And with that, I hope you have a good time with your Notion. Back to Valerie.
As I said, the potential to use Notion is very broad. We've just covered one small angle here for how to publish a website. If you'd like to see more, let us know in the comments below. If you're looking to set up your own website and looking for more options for the free and inexpensive versions out there, check out this playlist. Hit that like button to make sure more people can benefit from this content, and subscribe if you like this kind of thing. Good luck with it!